Hey everybody, welcome to Trina Kulik Designs. My name is Trina and I am the owner designer here at Trina Kulik Designs, where I teach other creative ladies how to cut, paint, and sell their wooden door hangers. So I've got a quick live for you, y'all. This is my day 29. Anyway, I'm so happy, y'all, that I've actually stuck with this and I'm getting through this 30 days of live. Hey Terry, hey Miss Regina, how are you ladies doing? So I want to share with you a quick little tip on how to ship your door hangers and to help you save money with shipping them flat rather than like a 4-inch box. So here's one door hanger that I have done that I'm going to ship. I used to order my boxes from Uline, but now I just pick them up from like Lowe's or Home Depot or Walmart. Walmart is where I pick them up from the most. So because I love Uline's boxes, y'all, but it costs an arm and a leg just to do the shipping from Uline. Hey ladies, if y'all don't mind, hit that little button down there and sprinkle the love for me. So this was one of the boxes I bought from Walmart. Yes, it's not pretty because it has all this writing and stuff, but y'all, what the outside looks like does not matter. It's what's on the inside of this box that your customers are going to really care about. So I always write like fragile. You can buy stickers if you want to. You know, I put like thank you, Miss Frida, on here. So this box was actually a lot bigger than this, and I don't have one to its full size. But I like put my door hangers in there and then I cut them down. I cut them down to fit snug around my door hanger. And this is the way that I will pack them up on the inside. So of course I have their little label and what they ordered and a personalized little thank you note written on that. I use Saran wrap and then I do have like this little cushion stuff. Not Saran wrap, y'all, but I call it Saran wrap. It's this, whatever this stuff right here is called. Hey, Grace. And then I put this little pad and stuff. These are like for when you're packing like plates, glass stuff that you can tear by in sections. So I'll just put like one little layer on top of that and then put that clear plastic wrap around it. With this one, it has a star so that, you know, it has a pointy edge, so I just took a piece of my box that I cut off and put it on my star there just to secure that little tip there a little bit. And now what I'm going to do is you're going to lift it up. You're going to put it in there just like that. And then you're just going to tape it up really, really good. And it's going to be kind of flat, and you're not going to have to worry about having to have shipping charges because of a 4-inch box or 4-inch deep box or whatever you want to call it. And this is basically kind of like what it's going to look like. This is one that I did. Now this, ladies, this door hanger has like 5 different door hangers in there. So it's a little bit more thicker. So you measure it and then most time with the height, I put that it's 1 to 2 inches. And it really helps save on shipping. And I have like my edges and stuff taped really, really good. So, but this is just the easy, quick way to do it and save money with shipping. Let me show y'all one more box. This is another little box that I buy from Walmart. See, it's got walmart.com right here. It's originally a 15 by 12 by 10. So I just ship them flat. I didn't cut this one out, like cut this one off at all. I just left it flat, just like this, slid my door hanger inside of it, put it down, and then I taped it up on my edges really, really good, and voila, flat shipping your door hangers. I use Pirate Ship when I ship my door hangers. Thank you, Donna, for sharing. I appreciate that. You love how the sled turned out. I did too, Christina. I had my doubts when we first got started with that thing, especially with Joy helping me, but it came together really good. Thanks for sharing your shipping routine. Oh, you're welcome, Miss Paula. Hey, Lisa. Hey, Amanda. Hey, Miss Sherry. That's just heavy duty saran wrap. You use it too? All right. Yeah, I was calling it saran wrap. I was like, I don't know if that was the correct term or what they called when you buy it out the shipping department, but we've always called it saran wrap. We've used to use it to cover up our dishes, our food. Yeah, so y'all, that's just a quick tip. How you can ship things flat when you're shipping out your door hangers to help the size of a box, because if you have a box that's way on bigger than your door hangers, I mean, most door hangers aren't but so thick, and if you put them in like a 4-inch box, you know, you got all that space inside that box that you're going to be paying for that you don't really need. So, hey, Miss Sandy, Kimberly said plastic wrap. Hey, Tanya. All right, so ladies, that's all I've got for you today. I was hoping that I would get to stain the sled with y'all today, but that's not going to happen because I've been making bows today to go on all of these orders for my live sale and getting them wrapped up, because here's the way I wrap mine, y'all. I have one here, like when I have like more than one order. So this one has one, two, three, four. This is four different ones here. So what I do is I put that foam stuff or whatever that's called in between each door hanger. Then I take that saran wrap and I just wrap it and I wrap it and I wrap it. That way it don't be like sliding up against each other. You don't have to worry about it like chipping each other's paint or scratching your door hangers. And I'm also going to ship these flat. Just like the other one, you know, it's a little bit more thicker, but you can still ship these flat. You don't have to worry about getting a big old box to ship these. So that's the way I do mine. And it just kind of holds them together. And you don't, like I said, it kind of secures them a little bit more. Or a lot more, really. All right. So, that is it. I was going to see if there was any more down here that I can kind of just show you right off. But most of them's pretty much the same. So, do y'all have any questions? Hey, Miss Linda. It does, Miss Kimberly. I think it really helps as long as you've got that saran wrap really tight. So I really enjoy using that. To weigh mine, I have this Salter Bregnail, whatever. I've had this scale, y'all. When you're shipping door hangers, you definitely want to be able to print your shipping labels from home. The reason for that is because it's so much cheaper to do it at home. You will save a couple of dollars, between $1 to $2, maybe even more, if you print your labels out at home. Get you some kind of scale. It doesn't matter the brand. I've had this one since I started, y'all. So, I mean, it's been a good one. I use regular, like, the duct tape. It's called the Easy Start Packing Tape by Duck. And I got my little tape dispenser thingy from Walmart, y'all. I just pick it up when I go there. I do have these trash bags. And I do have a few of mine that I've shipped this week. These are the clear, scent-free 30-gallon trash bags. I picked this up from Lowe's. And they're clear, so if you don't want to buy, like, the cello bag, whatever they are. I don't know, like the gift bags or whatever. You know, they're clear and they're big. And there's how many in here? 36, y'all. 36 in here. And you can actually use this as well to put around your door hangers. And, you know, I would probably tape it up really good. And I do use those. Hey, ladies. So there's your quick tip for today. I hope y'all have enjoyed this. I hope you've got some little tiny little nugget that you didn't know and found it very useful. If y'all have any questions, just let me know. And I will see y'all tomorrow. Y'all have a great, fantastic night.